First of all, I would like to thank very much to the organizer for inviting me and apologize once again for all the inconveniences I have done with my late applications. I'm going to tell you a few words about the last research we have done on the phylogeography of capercaillie, or as we say in English, 3B, big black bird. First of all, it is necessary to tell that it is not long time ago that capercaillie was a hunted species in all mountain areas in continental Europe, as well as in huge territories of Scandinavia and Russia. Nowadays, in most countries, it is protected. Exceptions is again Scandinavia and Russia, where the population sizes are huge. Nowadays, in most countries of Europe, it belongs to the threatened species, and much attention is paid for its protection, which is not very successful yet. Something about the taxonomy. As you can see, then there is one species in Europe. In total in the world, there are two species, Tetrao urogallus and Tetrao parvirostris in Siberia. And from this number, I think there are 12 altogether subspecies. There are two living in Iberic Peninsula in Spain, Cantabricus and Aquitanicus. And two are in continental Europe, and it is Tetrao urogallus major and Tetrao urogallus rudolfi. I have highlighted these two subspecies in red because the one should inhabit the central Europe up to Estonia, and the second one, southeast Europe, Bulgaria, Romania to southwest Ukraine. What was the aim of our study? The aim of our study was a little bit to extend the knowledge we have got by publishing the first paper. I will discuss it later on. And to investigate the genetic diversity of the populations along the Carpathians, and to investigate also the genetic structure of these populations. So we have managed to collect the samples from Slovakia. There is something wrong with the numbers, because from Slovakia we don't have 19 but 74, and 19 is in from Poland, 12 Ukraine, 60 Romania, 62 Bulgaria, and as the outgroup we have used the 8 samples from Russia, from Kirov region. From Russia and Bulgaria we had tissue samples, and the remaining populations that were non-invasive samples as feathers and feces, excrements. So the isolation of DNA was done using the kits, the stool mini kit or tissue extraction kit. We used 11 microsatellites of nuclear DNA, and we did also mitochondrial DNA sequencing using GALV primers. The total length of sequencing was 293. nucleotides. What were the results when comparing the population genetic characteristics? So the extreme values of expected heterozygosity were in range from 0.54 and to 0.66. while the lowest values were reached in Ukraine and the highest values in Romania, the similar values to the highest one were reached in Bulgaria or in Russia. This is nothing surprising. It is linked to the population size, and maybe the Ukraine, it is also not linked to the small number of figures, but the population size is also a little bit decreased. And observed heterozygosities are similar from 0.5 to 0.68 because the highest value was not reached in Romania but in Bulgaria, but it doesn't matter because there is only slight difference. And what concerns the inbreeding coefficients, so we have got some values which are showing the excess of heterozygotes and some values on the opposite side, deficit of heterozygotes, like in Ukraine. And something very shortly to tell you, because since we are designating the populations as a Poland and Slovakia, these territories where capercaillies are occurring are just over the border on the short geographical distances, but some comparison of some populations is a little bit on the larger geographic distances. For instance, if you are comparing Poland and Slovakia, the genetic distance is almost close to zero. That it means that there is one bigger population. Also the Romania and the Ukraine or Slovakia and the Ukraine. But on the other hand, if you are comparing Slovakia to Romania or Russia to Slovakia, we have got practically 5 to 10-fold larger differences. Yes, but how it looks like along the Carpathians? So when we were plotting the results using the principal coordinate analysis, it was shown the very clear picture that the Bulgarian populations are creating one group, the Russia is creating another group, and everything what is along the Carpathians is creating one mixture of dots, yellow and pink, and there are also green. And also there should be some other color, white. That is a very nice picture. So what does it mean that we have this picture? Because at the beginning I told you that Tetrao-Urogallus rudolfi should inhabit the territories from the southwest Ukraine down to Bulgaria. And Bulgaria is here, but the remainder of the dots, it is a mixture, and together also with the mixture of all populations we sampled along Carpathians. So we used the structure analysis to have a look how it looks like the individual samples, the entire population studies. So we can see very clearly the Bulgarian samples, it is one color with slight presence of some genes in very small proportion, which belong to the second group. And I would say everything from Ukraine to Poland, as well as Romania and also the Russian outgroup, it is just the opposite color, blue, with small admixture of the the Southeast European genes. We have increased the number of groups. So instead of two groups, we are expecting there are three groups. Yes, Bulgaria, it is the same picture. It has nothing common with Romania, with a neighboring country where also Tetrao-Urogallus rudolfi should be present. And in Ukraine as well, it should be also Tetrao-Urogallus rudolfi. So in this respect, I doubt whether such a subspecies existing at all. But what we can see very clearly, Poland and Slovakia, it is one color, Ukraine and Romania, it is another one. So from this picture, we could see some difference along the Carpathians between the eastern Carpathians and the western Carpathians, which are represented by Slovakia and Poland. Now, let's have a look on the sequencing. When we did sequencing, we used also some material from the gene bank. For instance, these samples from Tetrao-Parviros trees and these small samples, two samples from Cantabric mountains in Spain. So these are Bulgarian haplotypes. And they don't have nothing in common with the remainder, which is here. And it is this north, so-called northern lineage, the Carpathians and boreal forests, because there are also some samples from Sweden. The most frequent, however, is a very common, which is common also in Romania and Slovakia. This is another proof that I doubt that Tetraurogallus rudolfi, if it exists, is present in Romania. This is other picture from the dendrogram. We can see the Tetraoparviros trees, this black-billed capercaillie from eastern Siberia. It is a separate group. These are the samples from Bulgaria and these two samples from Spain, and the remainder is this structure to somewhat extent, but not very clearly, that we could distinguish, let me say, Romanian and Slovak populations. So it resembles very well our former paper we published 2 years ago in PLOS One with Slovenian colleagues, where we have included a lot of samples along the Balkan Peninsula. And it was also, here are these Tetraoparviros tree samples, and here are this, no, it, here, oh, this is, this ellipse should be over this text, and this one over this text. Sometimes the computers are not very cooperative. But this southern lineage, there are samples from Spain and Bulgaria and nothing else. And then we have this northern lineage, and there is a mixture of everything else, what is going in continental Europe and also in Scandinavia. Unfortunately, there were only a few samples from Russia. So this is a picture how it looks like along the Balkan. These Bulgarian populations were unfortunately only from two mountain ridges and from Rodopi and Rila, but we have still several several dots, let me say these squares, the presence of these Balkan samples in these along the Balkan Peninsula in Bosnia, and I think this one is from Montenegro. So using the landscape genetic analysis, we found there is a barrier, and the barrier is significant. There is no doubt. But the question is, how these capercaillies with these Bulgarian variants came to Western Balkan? This is a question. It should, they are flying usually, but when and how far? So, this is Romania. We found that in Romania there are completely different genetic variants as in Balkan. And I have now put several stars on the map. And this is something like a request, because I was last week in Bulgaria and I did some negotiations how to get the samples from Western Stara Planina, where the capercaillie should still be present, or the Stara Planina from the Serbian side, or this side is somewhere Golia in Serbia, or these dots are in Albania or maybe on Macedonian border. And these samples where there are stars are of value of gold. And why? We know there is a bridge between the Western Balkan and Bulgaria. We know there is a we know there is a gap between Bulgaria and Carpathians. We don't know nothing about these samples. Maybe this is a bridge to Carpathians. Maybe the barrier really exists. And also this barrier now is, I don't know, maybe it exists, maybe it is false. If it is false, it is due to the lack of samples. And if it is real, so we need to prove it. So this is approaching to the end of my story. We have to look, for this orthographic error. This is close to the end of my talk. If we have to prove the Tetraurogallus rudolfi, if it exists under this name, is existing. So it is existing only in Bulgaria. And it is necessary to look for the bridge, for the connectivity to the Carpathian populations and to the populations in Western Balkan. So thank you very much on behalf of all Capercaillies.